Good morning, children. Welcome back. We are continuing the chapter Nutrition and Plants. In this part, we will be studying about the synthesis of food other than carbohydrate. Yes, everybody knows during photosynthesis, glucose is synthesized. Glucose is a carbohydrate. It consists of carbon, hydrogen and oxygen. Glucose is a carbohydrate which consists of carbon, hydrogen, oxygen. It means C6H12O6. But the carbohydrate glucose is stored in the plant body as starch. So starch is the storage of the plants. Everybody knows it. Okay? Because the glucose is unstable, starch is stable. So starch is the stable form of carbohydrate which helps in the storage of the food in plants. Okay. Now in your body or in the body of the plants, the carbohydrate is used to synthesize proteins. For synthesis of protein, need nitrogen. Nitrogen is one of the component of the protein. So protein synthesis requires nitrogen. How do plants get nitrogen? Yes, plants get nitrogen in two ways. First of all, plants get nitrogen by nitrogen fixation. Plants get nitrogen by nitrogen fixation. Then second one, plants also get nitrogen by fertilizers rich in nitrogen. Okay, so we can say there are two ways by which the plants get nitrogen for synthesis of proteins. They are nitrogen fixation. First step is nitrogen fixation, which you know rhizobium bacteria. Which bacteria? Rhizobium. Rhizobium in the root nodules. Which root nodules? You can see rhizobium leaving the root nodules of legumes. For proteins, root nodules, you can understand the root nodules are seen in the legumes. Legumes or tree plants. Here you can see small nodules appear. Small nodules appear here. So these nodules contain rhizobium bacteria which absorb nitrogen from the atmosphere. Rhizobium bacteria leaving the root nodules or legumes absorb nitrogen from the atmosphere and convert nitrogen into nitrate compounds, water soluble nitrogen compounds. We call it nitrate. Water soluble nitrogen compounds called nitrate. And this nitrate being absorbed by the plants. So that is the first method. Second way, the fertilizers. Farmers add fertilizers rich in nitrogen to the soil. You got this idea? So plants get nitrogen. So what are the two ways by which nitrogen is available to the plants? The first method, the nitrogen fixation, by which the bacteria like rhizobium leaving the root nodules or legumes absorb nitrogen and convert nitrogen into nitrate compounds, water soluble nitrogen compound or nitrate compounds, so that the plants can absorb it. Second, the farmers add nitrogen containing fertilizers to the soil from which plants get nitrogen. So now you know what are the two ways by which plants get nitrogen. Clear. Now in the next subtopic we are going to study heterotrophic nutrition. So you have already been in touch with this subtopic in previous years. What is heterotrophic nutrition? The nutrition in which non-green plants. What are non-green plants? The fungi and bacteria.
also considers a plant.
Okay. So because this presence of silver in bacteria. So fungi and bacteria non green plants. They directly or indirectly depend on other sources for their food. Not only bacteria and fungi, even animals. Animals, bacteria and fungi, which depend on other sources for their food, and they cannot synthesize food, is called the heterotrophic nutrition. So what is heterotrophic nutrition? Nutrition which the green plants and animals depend on other sources for their food is called the heterotrophic nutrition. Now, green plants are autotrophs, but here non-green plants like fungi and bacteria heterotrophs. Now we understand the most important concept that these plants, non-green plants like fungi and bacteria, they get food from the dead and decomposing materials. The human being get food from other sources, even plants and animals. Based on this heterotrophic nutrition, we can say there are different types of organism or heterotrophic organism. The first one is parasites. Parasites are organisms, particularly microbes and some plants, which get food from the host. The parasites are organisms which get food from the host food. The host organisms provide food to the parasites. The parasites get food from the host organism. This is called the parasitic nutrition. In parasitic nutrition, dodder is a complete parasite. Complete parasite. What do you mean by this complete parasites? Dodder directly get food from the mango tree. Other plants. Wherever they go, from them directly they absorb the food. So a complete parasite is a parasite, they get complete food from the host plant. They cannot synthesize food. They cannot synthesize food. Such example is dodder. Now, there is another example, partial parasite. Partial parasites like mistletoe, other thing, castuta. Mistletoe or castuta, they are called partial parasite because they get food from the plant from which they live. Particularly, they get water and minerals from the mango tree. Mistletoe get water and minerals from the mango tree or mahua. Mango tree is also called mahua. And by using this water and minerals, the mistletoe or castuta synthesize food on their own. So they are called partial parasites. Why castuta or mistletoe is called partial parasite? Because the mistletoe or castuta get water and minerals from the host, that is mango tree. And then they synthesize their own food by photosynthesis. Hence, they are called partial parasites. Now, animals, if you come to animals, there are three groups of animals, herbivores, carnivores and omnivores. Animals are also heterotrophs, including humans. Now, there are three categories of animals, herbivores, carnivores and omnivores. Herbivores are animals which feed on directly on plants. For example, you can say cow, goat, buffalo, all these feed on plants directly. So they get directly food from the plants. They are called herbivores. Carnivores are animals like a tiger, lion, leopard. They feed on the flesh of other animals. Flesh of other animals. So indirectly they are feeding the plants. So carnivores indirectly feeding the plants because the animals which the carnivores feed on get food from plants. Okay? So carnivores are animals which feed on the flesh of other animals. So they are indirectly getting food from the plants. Now omnivores, human beings, crow, dog, bear, all these are omnivores.
human being also. We are both herbivores and carnivores. Together form the omnivores. We get food directly from the plants, as well as we get flesh from other animals. Hence, we are called omnivores. So this is all about the introduction about this chapter, and we can understand that the plants get nitrogen in two ways, through nitrogen fixation by rhizobium. Not only rhizobium, there is also bacteria, cyanobacteria, that is blue green algae. So fertilizers, farmers are the fertilizers in nitrogen. So plants get nitrogen from these two sources. But heterotrophic nutrition, you know that. There are different types of heterotrophic nutrition, parasites. First you have to understand, then partial parasites and the complete parasites. Then animals are three categories: herbivores, carnivores and omnivores. That's all from this part. Thank you.